Hello, welcome to my talk about the flute. This talk is only a collection to my talk on the principle of boundary element method for fluid structure interactions based on the potential flow theory. Hence, I would like to make a collection to the part of the example of a wind in a uniform flow. The example we looked at is a wind in a uniform flow, and we will see how we can establish the numerical method for the boundary element method. So, to solve the potential flow problem, the fluid domain is enclosed by a very large surface SC and the wind body surface SB. And the total potential function phi can be considered as a superimposition of the potential function F0 of the uniform flow and the potential function phi star due to the disturbance or existence of the wind. And the potential for the uniform flow can be simply given by this. In the far field, the disturbance potential function phi star would be roughly proportional to the reverse of R, and it vanishes in the far field. This is actually required from the mass and energy conservations. Also, in the far field, on the control surface, R would be very large, where the uniform flow would not be disturbed because the far distance from the wind in the uniform flow. So in the fluid domain enclosed by SC plus SB, the desingularization would lead to the boundary integral equation as this. Now we can make some mathematical manipulations and deductions to get the interesting result. The boundary integral equation is written as this on the boundaries SC plus SB. We can separate this into two parts based on the boundary SB and SC. And the integration on SC, we can further separate the potential function phi into the disturbance potential and the uniform potential at this. The first term on the boundary SC, the integrand would be roughly proportional to the reverse of R cubed. Hence, the integration would be zero when R is very large as this. So the boundary integral equation can be written as this. Now we examine the integration on SC, this term here. And based on the Green's theorem and the desingularization method, we could have the expression as this on the control surface SC, like this. The wind is either reduced to zero or non-existence. If we are interested in the potential in the fluid domain V and the expression of the uniform flow can be expressed as this. Since our interest is on the wind surface SB, which is actually in the fluid volume enclosed by the control surface, thus we have the expression this to phi zero. Our interest in the problem would be the disturbance potential function due to the wind. Therefore, the expression for the uniform flow on SB would be more useful in our application. So we can write the boundary integral equation on SB as this. From the equation, it can be seen the disturbance potential function is decided by the singularities on the body surface and the uniform flow potential phi zero. And this disturbance potential function is independent of the control surface SC. In the case of the fixed wing in the uniform flow, as we have seen in many practical applications, the boundary condition can be given as the non-penetration condition as this on the body surface. Apply this into the boundary integral equation. We could have equation as this and separate the potential function phi into the disturbance potential and the uniform potential. You have the boundary integral equation as this. Here, the potential for the uniform flow is known. Thus, the right-hand side of the equation can be regarded as the forcing term for the dynamic system. For a general application, we discretize the wing surface into n panels, and on each panel, the velocity potential function can be considered as a constant. Thus, on the wing boundary SB, we have the discrete equation as this. Here, it should be noted in the summation this and this. J should not equal to K, and RJK is defined as this, and the potential function of the uniform flow is given by this. If we define the coefficient AJK as this, we have the simultaneous equation for solving the disturbance potential function given by this equation. In this equation, the potential function of the uniform flow can be regarded as the forcing term in this side. Obviously, if the forcing term is zero, then the disturbance function would be zero.